Hello everyone, what's up? Welcome to a new quick edit video. And this time I want to work on another composite image. That means I'm using this image and here I'm replacing the sky and insert an image of the Milky Way in the background. So of course there will be heavy editing going on, and for this I only will be using Adobe Photoshop and maybe make use of the Nick Collection plugin as well. So before I start, let's first take a look at the before and after images. Alright, here I am in Photoshop in the Camera Raw Editor, which is basically the same as Lightroom, just with a different user interface. And I want to start by changing the profile from Adobe Color to Adobe Standard. This would just make the darker parts of the image a little bit brighter and thus reduce the contrast. Then for the white balance I am going with Cloudy. This would just increase the warmth of the image a little bit. Actually, I think I'm even dropping the temperature, since I'm turning this into a nighttime shot and the foreground needs to be a little bit colder in this case. Then let's play around with the exposure balancing. As I'm turning this into a nighttime shot, I'm dropping the exposure. Also, I'm making sure the foreground can easily be separated by the sky. And for this reason, the sky needs to be brighter than the foreground. But for now, let's increase the shadows a little bit so I get some details in the darker parts. And then to make the selection of the sky a little bit easier, I could increase the whites, I guess. I just don't want to make the foreground too bright. Then I want to add some structure and more detail to the stuff in the foreground, and I'm doing that by increasing the texture a little bit and the clarity as well. Okay, then let's do some color grading in the HSL tab. First I want to drop the green hue to change the color of the grass in the foreground, and maybe let's drop the yellow hue as well. Then let's head over to the saturation tab and drop the green saturation a bit. Then let's head over to the split toning. Here I'm just working on the shadows, and that means I'm applying a cold color tone to them. And this will just help make this image look more like a nighttime shot. Okay, and then last I want to sharpen the image. Okay, then let's open it. Now, first of course, I want to work on the sky replacement, and usually I would go for something like luminosity masks, which makes complex sky replacements rather easy. But since the contrast between the sky and the foreground is quite strong, I think I can just go with a quick selection tool and brush over the sky. And you can see Photoshop does a really great job at selecting this stuff. Alright, then let's apply a layer mask. And of course now we need to invert the mask by hitting Ctrl+I. And here we have a nice foreground. Then let's insert the new Milky Way sky. Okay, and place it in the back. Now I want to position it real quick. Maybe let's rotate it a bit to get some more dynamic in this image. And let's fill those gaps. Alright, now you can still see the foreground doesn't look really natural under the new sky, but that's not a big deal. Need to further drop down the exposure, and therefore I'm applying a curves adjustment layer. Let's create a clipping layer by holding down the Alt key and pressing between those two. This means this curves adjustment layer only will affect the layer right beneath it. And then let's make it a little bit darker. And maybe let's head to the blue curves and increase the blue tone slightly. Okay, then let's apply a vibrance adjustment layer, create a clipping layer again and drop the vibrance. Alright. Then I want to work on the sky a little bit and insert some kind of heavy glow effect just above the horizon. So I'm selecting the Milky Way layer and here I'm creating a new layer. Switch the blending mode to overlay first. Then I'm grabbing the brush and select a nice warm sunset-like color. And let's change the brush opacity and then paint in right there. Okay, then let's apply a new layer one more time, switch the blending mode to hard light this time, and again start painting in this area. Let's change the foreground color. Okay. Now, of course, I need to add some glow on the foreground as well. So I'm going all the way to the top and create a new layer again. Switch the blending mode to hard light again. And let's drop the brush opacity further. Change the foreground color once more. And then let's carefully add some glow here. And I actually want to make it look like it's overexposed. I think it's just a nice effect. I could even add some more colors in there by creating another new layer and switching the blending mode to overlay. And then let's add some color tones. Okay, I think that looks pretty awesome. Now, I also want to apply a glow effect on some of those stars in the sky. So let's apply a new layer, switch the blending mode to hard light. And this time I'm choosing a cold foreground color. Just paint over some of those stars. Maybe let's drop the opacity of this layer. Okay. And then I want to merge all those layers I just created. So I'm selecting every layer, go to layer and merge visible. So now let's play around with the Nick collection a little bit. Yeah, I want to go with the classical soft focus, which adds this nice dreamy look to the image. And under the method drop-down menu, I am going with the first diffusion method and apply it. Alright, I still want to have some sharpness in this tree, so let's apply a layer mask, grab the brush tool, and then I'm just painting over the tree in the foreground. Okay, maybe let's also mask out some of those brighter areas. But I think that's it, and I'm quite satisfied with this image. So I hope this was interesting and helpful. Of course, if you have any questions regarding the editing, then please let me know in the comments. And thank you very much for watching this video.